So we were all sitting around the dinner table eating Antonello's pasta when Sarah says, "I have an incredible story to tell you, and it's true." And this is the story she told. Her friend Julie was asked to babysit for some neighbors who were going to a wedding reception, and they told her that they would probably be home around 2 in the morning, so they left the number where they could be reached, just in case of an emergency. The parents left, and the children were in the family room watching a freak flick on TV. You know, the Friday the 13th kind that really gets your skin crawling. Julie was in the kitchen at the time. All of a sudden, the kids came running into the kitchen screaming something about the large cactus plant that they received from a mail-order catalog out of Arizona. "Julie! Julie! The cactus plant is moving! It's swaying back and forth!" Julie laughed. "Come on, you're just scared from that movie you were watching. Why don't you go back and change the channel, and I'll make some popcorn for you." Well, the kids went back into the family room, but 2 minutes later they came running into the kitchen again, yelling some more about this cactus. "Julie, please come and look. The cactus is moving again." So Julie followed the kids into the family room, and sure enough, there was the cactus rocking back and forth like it was dancing to some music that nobody could hear. Julie didn't know what to do, and she got real nervous about it. So she called the parents at the wedding reception. The parents were rather irritated when they heard the news. "You mean to tell us there's a cactus dancing in our family room?" they said. "Look, Julie, put the kids back to bed, and we'll be home soon." Julie hung up the phone and went back to the family room. This time the cactus was gyrating completely out of control. Julie panicked and ran back into the kitchen. She dialed 911 and said, "You're going to think I'm completely nuts, but I'm babysitting for some people who have a cactus that's dancing all over the place." The police told her that it was a little out of their jurisdiction, but she could call the botanical hotline and maybe they could help. So she did, and as soon as she described the problem, the voice on the other end of the phone said, "What's it doing?" She said, "It's rocking back and forth." And then the voice said, "Get out of the house immediately and take the children with you. Your lives are in danger. We'll call the fire department from here." Julie went hysterical. She slammed down the phone and rushed the kids out of the house. An entourage of police cars and fire trucks pulled up. Some firemen wearing what looked like spacesuits marched into the house and brought the cactus outside. At this point, the parents arrived home and saw a whole mess of police cars, fire engines, and people in spacesuits on the front lawn. The firemen then got a flamethrower and proceeded to torch the cactus. And as it burned, it split open and thousands of tarantula spiders spilled out and cooked in the flame of the fire. Apparently, cacti from Arizona and other similar geographic locations must be legalized before they can be sold out of state. You see, tarantulas lay their eggs in these cacti, and in this particular one, there were thousands of them, and they all eventually hatched. And Julie never went back to that house to babysit again. True.